We've worked closely with NVIDIA to integrate our networking and our virtualization capabilities with their chips to bring our GPU instances to customers. And today, I'm thrilled to announce that we are expanding our partnership with NVIDIA with more innovations that are going to deliver the most advanced infrastructure for generative AI workloads with GPUs. And I'd like to invite Jensen Huang, founder and CEO of NVIDIA, here on stage with us to tell us more. Jensen, so good to see you.
I'm thrilled to be here.
Yeah, thank you so much for joining us today. It's amazing. So as I've just discussed, we've got a long partnership, AWS and NVIDIA have been doing this a long time together. I'm so excited about how the teams are collaborating. You and I were talking about that backstage. The collaboration's amazing. It's been happening for a lot of years, and I'm just thrilled to deepen the partnership.
Thank you. It's great to be here. I'm thrilled to be here to celebrate the amazing work of our two teams and to help announce our big new partnership. You know, we've been working together for a very long time. In fact, AWS was the world's first cloud to recognize the importance of GPU accelerated computing. And you put the world's first GPUs in the cloud a long time ago. And since then, this is an amazing statistics. In the last several years alone, just for the Ampere and Hopper generation, we've put up, deployed, 2 million GPUs in AWS. That's 3 zettaflops, 3,000 exascale supercomputers. Most nations would be happy with 1 exascale supercomputer. AWS has 3,000 of them, and we are just getting started. I'm delighted to see that we are going to announce today a deployment of a whole new family of GPUs, the L4, the L40S, and the brand new H200. The H200, this is really an amazing thing. The combination between the brand new TensorRT LLM optimizing compilers for generative AI and H200 improves the throughput of inference, large language model inference, by a factor of 4, reducing the cost in just 1 year by a factor of 4. Now, our collaboration starts with, of course, great GPUs. And we're ramping so incredibly fast. Each quarter, we're standing up and deploying more than 1 zettaflops more in AWS. 1 zettaflops more each quarter. It's an unbelievable number. And all of this is, of course, made possible because of the accelerated computing libraries. Our two teams stood up a whole bunch of new infrastructure, but we're also bringing our most popular libraries, the NVIDIA AI stack, our NeMo LLM, large language model framework, the retriever inference model for RAGs, our BioNeMo digital biology, large language model foundation models, Isaac Sim on Omniverse for robotics. This is something that Amazon Robotics uses to simulate its robots, and it's incredible warehouses that you guys do. Just all of these stacks, software stacks and libraries, we're going to integrate into AWS. So our two teams have been really, really busy.
Busy indeed, and that was a lot of Zetas and everything. Yeah. As you said, the collaboration is going to enable developers to access amazing technology, and they're going to need it to innovate with generative AI. Now, one of the big announcements, of course, is that AWS is going to be the first cloud provider to bring the latest NVIDIA GH200 Grace Hopper Superchips with a new multi-node NVLink to the cloud, first place. And maybe you could tell us a little bit more about that, what makes that computing platform so powerful, and how we're working together to introduce it.
Well, we're both really passionate about ARM processors. And the reason why ARM is so incredible is because we can mold it to exactly the type of computing needs that we have. It's incredibly low energy. It's incredibly cost effective. And so Grace Hopper, which is GH200, connects two revolutionary processors together in a really unique way. It connects them together using a chip-to-chip interconnect called NVLink at 1 terabyte per second. And it's connected in a coherent way so that the GPU could access all of the CPU's memory, the CPU can access all of the GPU's memory, and so the two of these processors could work hand in hand in a really fast way. The second thing that we did was we invented a new way of extending NVLink to a very large domain. So now 32 Grace Hoppers could be connected by a brand new NVLink switch, and that becomes one unit. And with the Nitro, AWS Nitro, that becomes basically one giant virtual GPU instance. I mean, you got to imagine this. You've got 32 H200s, incredible horsepower in one virtual instance because of AWS Nitro. And then we connect it with AWS EFA, your incredibly fast networking. All of these units now can create into an ultra cluster, an AWS ultra cluster. So I can't wait to see all this come together.
I mean, it's really, it's an incredible combination. I mean, how customers are going to use this stuff, one can only imagine. I know that the GH200s are really going to supercharge what customers are doing. It's going to be available, of course, in EC2 instances coming soon. Now, in the world of generative AI, you know, a lot of companies are looking to onboard AI into their business. And it's great to see the infrastructure, but it extends to the software, the services, and all of the other workflows that they have. So this leads, of course, to the second big announcement we have today. So partnering AWS and NVIDIA to bring the NVIDIA DGX Cloud to AWS. And I'd love to hear about a little bit about how the DGX Cloud is an important platform for customers.
Well, first of all, DGX Cloud is NVIDIA's AI factory. This is how our researchers advance AI. We use AI to do neural graphics. The way we do computer graphics today is impossible without AI. We use our AI factories to advance our digital biology models, our large language models, use it for robotics, for self-driving cars. We use it to simulate Earth 2, to a digital twin of the Earth to predict weather and climate. And so DGX Cloud is really important to us. We're incredibly excited to build the largest AI factory NVIDIA has ever built. We're going to announce inside our company, we call it Project Ceiba. Ceiba, you all probably know since you're at an AWS conference, is the largest, most magnificent tree in the Amazon. We call it Project Ceiba. Ceiba is going to be 16,384 GPUs connected into one giant AI supercomputer. This is utterly incredible. We will be able to reduce the training time of the largest language models, the next generation MOEs, these large, extremely large mixture of experts models, and be able to train it in just half of the time, essentially reducing the cost of training in just 1 year in half. Now we're going to be able to train much, much larger multimodal MOE models, these next generation large language models. These 16,000 GPUs will be 65 exaflops. It's like 65 exascale supercomputers in one. And so I can't wait for us to stand this up. Our AI researchers chomping at the bit. Now, of course, this is also a place where we collaborate with partners and customers who need to build custom AI models. You know, it's great to be able to use off-the-shelf models, and there's gonna be a whole bunch of off-the-shelf models in public clouds. It's going to be available in software platform companies, SaaS companies, for example, Salesforce that you mentioned earlier. They'll have all kinds of off-the-shelf co-pilots and generative AI models. But a lot of companies need to build their own proprietary models. And so we set up the AI factory so that we could partner with them to help them create their custom AIs. And now it'll run all on AWS. We'll develop the model on AWS, collaborate with our customers on AWS, connect them all to your services and storage services, security services, and all kinds of other generative AI services, and then deploy it all in AWS. So we're going to be able to do this very first time in AWS.
It's all amazing. I mean, you guys have been doing amazing things. You know, we've been working hard to see us come together even more tightly. I mean, it's just going to bring incredible benefits to customers who are really going to need it. We appreciate the collaboration. Appreciate working with you, and look forward to a lot more of that going forward.
Thank you, Adam.
All right. Thank you, Jensen.
Have a great show, everybody.